This is a basic video on technical SEO here. In this video, I'm going to cover about technical aspect of SEO. Hello friends, I'm Shivani Goyal. Welcome in WS Cube Tech. So let's start learning technical SEO. In this video, I'm going to cover what is technical SEO, what's our need of technical SEO, technical SEO monitoring and audit, benefit of doing technical SEO, and in the last, I'm going to discuss about technical SEO checklist as well. Okay, so let's start with the basic definition of technical SEO. Technical SEO is the process of ensuring that a website meets the technical requirement of modern search engine with the goal of improving organic ranking. Okay, so as we already know, what is the goal of SEO here? To improve your organic ranking on search engine result page. Okay, so just to improve your ranking here, we are covering technical aspect of SEO here. Okay, next we have technical SEO refers to your website and server optimization. For example, if there is any server error in your website, or if you have any crawling error in your website, any indexing error in your website, then with the help of technical SEO, we can improve that and we can help search engine spider crawl and index your website more effectively to help improve organic ranking as well. Okay. Next, do you really need technical SEO? As we already cover on page SEO, off page SEO, but why we need technical SEO here? Because it can deal with the web crawler and making it more convenient for them to judge your content. In case of technical SEO, we work on a tool which is known as Google Search Console or Google Webmaster. Okay, this is a tool here. And with the help of this tool, we can check our website pages that they crawling or not, they are indexing or not. If they are not indexed, then we can also index these pages. And if there is any error, we can also resolve that error. And that's why we can say that it is more convenient for them to judge your content with the help of these particular tool. Okay, so search engine robots access website based upon several factors before ranking it. Okay, and the most crucial one is your user experience. Next, similarly, loading time are very relevant. We can also improve your loading time with the help of technical SEO. Web pages are supposed to load super fast and not bother visitors with unnecessary long loaded time. Website loading speed is the most important ranking factor online. Next is our technical SEO monitoring and audit. Technical SEO simple aim at upgrading certain elements of the web pages and making them more accessible. And what are these elements? These elements are crawling. Crawling means exact useful data your Google Spider is getting by extracting data from your site. Okay. After crawling, we have analyzing. We have to figure out your insights. What is your data insight? Okay, how your site is performing. Just look at the performance of your website. Look at the overview of your website. Okay. Next is your optimizing. In case of optimizing, whatever be the changes required in your website, we can work on that. And next one is our monitoring. In case of monitoring, we can monitor our performances, our indexing, our organic traffic. Okay, so these are the things which are done by technical SEO. So that's why we can say that technical SEO help in monitoring and audit our website. Next, we have some other benefits of technical SEO as well. Addressing to Google's best practices for website optimization. Having a mobile friendly website that users can access from any device. Ensuring your website load quickly for all users. Just by improving your website speed, you can work on your loading speed. Making your website easy for search engine to crawl, index and rank, we can use technical SEO here. Removing any pop-ups and other intrusive elements that hinder your user experience. Making your website easy for users to navigate and find the information they need. Keeping your website safe and secure, we also need technical SEO here. We can, because with the help of technical SEO, we can also detect if there is any threat in our website, if there is any manual threat action is happening on our website, so we can also track that. Okay, so these are some important benefits of SEO here. Now let's move on the technical SEO checklist, like what are the activities we are covering in our technical SEO part. Okay, and all this activity we will cover in detail and in practical manner in our technical SEO module here. So as we divide this particular checklist in four main parts, first one is this website loading speed time. Okay, with the help of technical SEO, we can work on website loading speed and time. In this, we will work on improving server response time. We work on optimizing and reduce image size without affecting the visual appearance, like without affecting your image quality. We are minimizing the render blocking JavaScript and CSS. We limit the number of resources and HTTP requests. We set a browser cache policy. We reduce the number of redirects and eliminate redirect loop. We avoid loading your speed with too much stuff. Okay. Next one is website functionality and usability. In your technical SEO, we also work on functionality and usability here. If I'm talking about functionality, so we must make sure that our website is mobile friendly. Okay. Build search engine friendly URL, because in case of that friendly URL, you don't need to put your parameters and the number here. You have to simply structure your URL in this way that it is easy in readable form for your search engine as well as for your user. Okay, use a secure protocol, that is HTTPS. How it's happening? With the help of SSL certification. As you purchase down your domain name, so as the same process is happening for purchasing your SSL certificate. And if your website is SSL certified, then it is automatically convert from HTTP to HTTPS. Okay, set up correctly the 301 redirects after your site migration. Make sure your resources are crawlable. Test your robots.txt file to show Google the right content. Okay, in this robots.txt file, we will inform our search engine spider that these are the links which are in disallow. It means you don't need to crawl these link information here. Okay, and if you are not adding any link in robots.txt file and this particular link is added in your sitemap or in your website, so this is automatically allowed by you, that you allowing search engine spider to read that particular link here. Verify the indexed content. Review your sitemaps to avoid being outdated. In case of sitemap, you have a txt file where you can mention all the links available on your website which you want to crawl. Review your blog resources, like your hashbang URLs with the fetches Google. Optimize your crawl budget. Now, what is this crawl budget here? In this crawl budget, it means that how many times your Google spider visit on your website in the given allotted time. Let's suppose this is your website and your web spider visit on your website, crawl every information. This is one. Again, if you are doing any changes here, again your web spider visit on your website, read every information, this is two. So now your crawl budget is two here. Avoid meta refresh for moving a site. Use redirects for flash site to the HTML versions. Use HREFLang for languages and relational URL. In case of HREFLang, what is this HREF here? Let's suppose if your website is right now in English language and you want to make your website in German language. Okay, in that case, you are using same content as you are mentioned in English language here. In that case, if you are not using your HREFLang or any particular plugin in your website, in that case, Google considered that these are two websites and they both having same content. It means there must be an issue of duplicate content here. So we can work on that with the help of technical SEO. make sure that your tracking is working properly. With the help of technical SEO, we can monitor our every activity, and that should be properly done. Next is content optimization. With the help of technical SEO, we can also work on our content optimization as well. How we can do that? Just redirect, replace your broken links and resources. We can improve, we can just remove our broken links from our pages, like we can remove our web page from our website. Audit internal links to improve your chances to rank higher. Get rid of duplicate content. Use structured data to highlight your content. Keep a reasonable number of links on your on page. Avoid canonicalization blog page to the root of the blog. What is this canonicalization means? It means, let's suppose you have one single product, and for this single product we have two links available on my website, and these two links are for only one product here. So in that case, this is known as canonicalization. In that case, you can only choose one link for this particular product here. Next, we have user-friendly website. With the help of technical SEO, we can make user-friendly website here. We can set up AMP in the right way just to make your website mobile friendly. We can add breadcrumbs. What is the breadcrumbs? This is the navigation, as you can see on some of the websites like Amazon, Flipkart. In this, starting from your home page, then your category page, and then your product page. So this is the navigation here. You can see breadcrumbs. You can add breadcrumbs in your website so that when any particular visitor visit on your product page, so they can also see your category page and home page as well. So test on as many platform and devices as possible. Okay, so this is the checklist of your technical SEO. This is just the basic of technical SEO. In our technical SEO module, we will cover a lot about it. So thank you so much for watching this video.